in the new published report, Facts and Figures for Hispanics, Latinos, I think one of the things that is most important to note is that there's actually has been a decline in both mortality and incidence between 2000 and 2009. Cancer has surpassed heart disease as the number one killer among Hispanic Latino populations since 2009. In the report, it was published that while we are making progress with cancer among Hispanic and Latino populations, there are still some challenges, particularly in the area of cancer incidence for stomach, liver, and gallbladder disease, as well as cervical cancer. I think important barriers to care include access to quality and timely care, both for screening and for treatment and follow-up as well. I think also as the population continues to grow, the capacity within our current healthcare system may not necessarily meet their needs, particularly in the area of linguistics. So having individuals with which they can communicate in both English and Spanish, which is important, I think continues to be a barrier. Promoting healthy lifestyle choices is really important in this population, particularly when we see higher rates of obesity within the population and lack of healthy foods and also access to physical activity, or at least ability to have walkable areas, have parks and recreation areas that may not necessarily be available in all communities. So as people come to this country, there's actually protective factors that they bring as they immigrate with more healthy lifestyles in countries of origin. However, once they acculturate and assimilate into the country and unfortunately adopt some of our unhealthy lifestyles within this country, they have poor health outcomes, not only in cancer, but in other chronic diseases as well. If you add to that the barriers to care in terms of access to quality care and timely care, it really may paint a bleaker picture than we currently see reflected in the numbers.